Do you want to know how to paint bottles with acrylic colors? In this video, I'm exactly going to show you that. Hi, this is Madhula, the artist behind Madhula Creations, helping you to learn to draw, paint and relax through art. This video has three sections with lot of tips throughout. The first section is on how to prepare the base of your bottle. The second is on how to paint on the bottles, and the third is how to protect your bottles. Finally, I'm also going to show you how this bottle will look under light. So let's get started. I have different shape and size bottles here. Some have wide opening like this and some have smaller opening like this one here. So first let's see how to cover the bottles with acrylics, or I can also say it as how to prepare the base for the painting. Okay. I'm going to show you three different methods of covering or preparing the bottles. The first method is to use a paintbrush and paint the base of the bottle. You can use a bottle paint or a tube acrylic paint. You can also use an acrylic gesso to do this. So I'm going to use a gesso. This is an acrylic primer. Gesso will usually be very thick. I will show you here. So if you apply it as it is, there will be lot of brush marks. Okay, so just add a touch of water and start painting the bottle with a brush. Ensure you paint only in one direction so that it looks neat and uniform. Also, go from top to bottom of the bottle, covering all of the areas. Before you start with the process of painting on the bottle has to be clean. Just wash it nicely and allow it to dry. The bottle has to be completely dry before you do anything on it, alright? Ensure to cover the top portion as well. And once the first layer is done, allow it to completely dry. Now this is dry, I will start with the second layer. You can use the same method and cover the entire bottle. We have to do 2 or 3 coats to make it clean and nice. Here I am doing 2 coats. By the end of it, you will have a uniform base layer. The second method for covering the bottle is to use a sponge. Take a sponge and dip it in the gesso and start dabbing in the bottle like this. You don't need to add water for this method. This is a sponge dab technique and you will get a very nice textured base. Ensure that you cover every portion of the bottle, including the top edge. Allow it to dry completely before you paint anything on top of this. The third method of covering the bottle is by covering it inside. So both of the previous methods of filling will give you an opaque style of acrylic painting on bottle. But if you want a more transparent look, here is the method. So take a paper cup and get some paint of the color choice that you want your bottle to be filled. Now I'm going to mix pouring medium to this. You can use any brand pouring medium, it doesn't matter. So I'm going to use a Liquitex pouring medium. So just open it up and add quantity equal to your paint or little bit more than that. So whatever quantity you are taking, add equal amount of pouring medium and start mixing it. So I'll show you the consistency where you need to stop. So this is the consistency we want. So I've added more pouring medium to it. So it has to drip drop by drop and it has to be little thicker than we use it for the pour colors. So as you can see, it has to flow like that, then only it can flow in the bottle very easily. So now just pour that into the bottle and start rotating the bottle. you have to just keep rotating. Since it is thicker, it takes a lot of time and patience to cover the bottle, but you will have a very uniform layer throughout the bottle. Now it is little more thicker, but as the paint drips down, the opacity will reduce because we have used the pouring medium. Just allow it to dry like this upside down. So for every 1 or 2 hours, just keep moving the bottle so that the residual paint flows off. After all the residual paints or the extra paint comes off, then you can allow the bottle to dry on its base. In this technique, there will be lot of paint wastage. So one thing you can do is you can use a plastic mat or something and use the residual paint for some other mixed media art or making a jewelry piece. All that you can use this. It will completely take 2 to 3 days for this kind of a filled bottle to completely dry. So have patience till then. Here is the finished dried bottle. So as you can see, it's not very opaque as the acrylic paints, but at the same time you will get a little bit of transparency like the glass paints. Now that you have the base, now we will paint it up. Okay, how to paint bottles with acrylic? I'm going to show you 3 methods of painting. Method 1 is to paint on the base that we have already created. You can design simple flowers, geometric patterns, or designs of your choice. I'm going to do flowers in these bottles, so I'll create a green base first. Since we already have a nice white base, the colors will pop up more and it gives a nice look to the finished bottle. I am using just 3 colors, Pinus Grey, Sap Green and Yellow. Start from dark green and as you move up, add yellow to it. Finally, finish off with the yellow on top. One layer will be enough. On top of this, start with a flower. I do post video tutorials with step-by-step instructions like this one, detailed product reviews and much more on my channel every week. So do subscribe and also click on the bell icon so that you get notifications from YouTube whenever I post a new video. Keep painting the bottle with your choice of acrylic paints. Allow it to completely dry. And this is how the end result will look like. I'm going to paint 2 layered flowers on top of this. First, let's paint some of that flowers. I'm using a cadmium red and a Prussian blue for the flowers. Kind of a one stroke painting where I took one side with a darker blue and the other side I loaded the brush with a red. And you can do this very easily. First practice on a paper and then bring it onto your glass. So you can paint flowers like this throughout the bottle wherever you want. You can do bigger flowers, smaller flowers, it doesn't matter. Next, paint the grass. Now, similar to how you did the flowers, you can also load the brush with both yellow and green and do the grass. Do as many grass as you want and just try to fill the entire bottle. That way it will look really nice. So I'm using a combination of sap green, a permanent light green and yellow. All these colors alternatively for each of the grass. Now let's add some more flowers. The same way, we will load the brush with red and blue and do these flowers. Now you can finally add small flowers, like 2 or 3 petals, which are very small and kind of closed flowers. Once that is done, go ahead to do the second layer of petals. So it's going to be a combination of orange and blue and little bit of yellow. In the center, now we'll fill it with yellow and brown. Add stem for each of the flower and finish with the lavender flowers. Grass and lavender flowers, I have already covered it in the previous video. I'll put a link in the card above and in the description box below, and in case you have missed watching that, check it out. So use dark and light purple and finish off wherever you wanted it to be added. Here is the finished piece. It looks really nice and the texture has given it a much deeper look. What do you think about it? Let's dive into method 2. In this method, I will show you how you can paint directly on the plain bottle. I am going to paint daisy flowers. Since we have no base layer to it, it takes a lot of paint to bring out this effect. So my suggestion is to use tube acrylic paints because they are more pigmented and also they are thick. In the center, you can use a brown and a yellow. And for the petals, I'm going to use 2 colors. The first one, I'm going to do a white flower. So wherever you want these flowers to be, just go ahead and add them. Now for the second flower, let's add yellow flowers. So it's a pretty simple and easy method to do daisies. Load your brush and just pull off the paint. Same way as we did the white flowers, you can fill the yellow flowers wherever you want. I will also add some grass to it now. You will need to go over it 2 or 3 times to get the depth and darkness of each of those colors because the bottle is plain, right? Otherwise, it will look very pale. This is also because we don't have any base layer. But then this bottle painting gives a completely different effect. So do try it out too. Now add some stems connecting the flowers to the grass. And we will start with the second layer of the grass. So this time we will keep it still more lighter than the underlying base layer, which is a very dark green. Now I am adding more yellow to the green to make it more bright and nice. Also, we don't have a base layer, right? So let's make it still more brighter. Now I am adding flowers on top of this grass. The procedure remains the same. Just start with the center of brown and yellow and cover as many flowers as you want. So I am covering it with both yellow and white flowers. And finally add white dots to make it little pop out. Okay, here we go. So let's complete this with more dots. Yes, here is the finished piece. It looks really, really nice, mainly because of the transparent nature of the glass. How do you like it? Now for the method 3. This can only be done on bottles with a wider opening. We are going to paint it from inside and not outside. So for this bottle, I am going to paint sunflowers. I am starting from the middle part. It's going to be browns and yellows. Just dab the colors. Then we will do the petals with yellows. You can continue to do this and add as many flowers as you want. For the petals, I'm using a lemon yellow and cadmium yellow. You can also bring in yellow ochre to have a slight difference in the petal colors. So just load both the colors in the brush and paint the petals one by one. Add more flowers. For each of the flowers, you have to add the petals the same way. Just load primary yellow, or you could also use a lemon yellow and cadmium yellow, and finish off the petals. So this is the second flower here. We will continue to paint more flowers. So keep the size different. For example, some of the flowers you can keep it bigger and some of them you can keep it very, very small. Once that is done, you can add some green grasses to make it like more interesting. And you have to do this step only after your sunflower dries, because we'll be going on top of it when painting the greens and we don't want to tamper the sunflowers, right? So allow your sunflowers to completely dry and then do the green area. So what's the advantage of painting inside the bottle? First, it's easy to maintain because we are not doing anything in the outside of the glass, right? So it makes it very easy for cleaning. Secondly, since the paint is inside, you will not be able to see the brush marks or the paint strokes outside. So it gives a definitely very nice and clean look when we are seeing it from out. If you don't want a transparent look for the glass, once the grass dries, you can also fill the entire bottle with your acrylic colors as the third layer and have it as a very opaque one. How to protect acrylic painting on glass? I'm going to exactly show you how vulnerable acrylic colors on glass bottle. So just for experiment purpose, I'm going to write two alphabets here. The first is an A, so let's write it very thick. I'm using two layers here, and on the opposite side, let's have a B. Same way, we will go with two layers to make it little more thick. I'm going to allow it to completely dry. Now that it is completely dry, I'm going to varnish on one side, which is the A side, and just keep the other side as it is. So I'm holding a white sheet at the back so that B doesn't get tampered. And I'm going to use a normal acrylic varnish for this. It's a spray type varnish and just one or two coats, and I'm going to allow it to dry completely again. So as you can see, there is a slight tint, kind of a frosted look on the glass, right? And just remember, so if you are going to varnish, you will get that frosted look on the plain glass. So now let's apply water on the B surface, which is not protected. So it's just the acrylic paint. It's a normal tap water, okay? So as you can see, it's coming off. It's very, very easily damageable. So if you are just going to paint acrylic on bottle, ensure that there is no touch of water. Do not clean the bottle with water or not even with a damp cloth. It's going to damage the paint that you have laid in. Now let me just wipe this off and allow the side to completely dry and show you what will happen if we scratch the paint. As you can see, even scratching will pull off the paint from the glass. Now let's come to the varnished side. Same way, I'll apply water and just try to take off the paint from the glass surface. I am trying it for several times to check whether the paint is coming off. So let me put little more pressure and little more time into it to see if the paint is off. Not really, it's not coming off. Now for the scratch test, with mild effort I was not able to remove the paint, but with hard scratching I was able to pull off the paint. In terms of protection, so this is definitely better than the other side. You can go ahead to use at least 2 coats of varnish to ensure that it's well protected. Another thing is, do not use too much of varnish because the varnish might drip at the sides and you will not have a uniform layer covered over the painting. So always use minimum varnish but increase your layers when you are doing in the glass. There are also other ways to protect the glass. You could use a glass varnish or you could also use a Mod Podge. This is dishwasher safe Mod Podge. Okay, so you can apply a thin layer over your work. So use a flat brush and just apply it over your work. So once it dries, this is how it looks. It will dry very transparent and you will be able to see your artwork and the inside material very well. There will be little brush strokes, but that will not be very much visible. Okay, so this is an alternative of varnishing the glass. Before we move on to the final results, in case you are interested in more acrylic tips, download my free guide from the link book.modelercreations.com. This is a free PDF ebook. And now I'll show you the difference between the opaque glass that we did and the transparent one that we made. So I will light a fairy light inside so that you can see the opacity. Here is how it looks. You can use it in any creative way you want. So this is the transparent one. As you can see, you will have a brighter light out of it. And here is the opaque acrylic painting that we did on the glass. So you will get it like a night lamp kind of an effect. Both will look very beautiful at night. So try all these methods and let your creativity and imagination take its place to decorate your bottles. In this holiday season, do prepare to gift your loved ones. And all these bottles painted beautifully with acrylics will be wonderful gifts. Hope you enjoyed creating all these wonderful bottles. If you like what you saw and if you got value from this video, do click on the like button and do share it with your friends too. Do subscribe and let's stay in touch. Here is the list of useful videos for you to watch and enjoy. Have a great week and happy painting.